The barf diet is one of the most popular ways of raw feeding among pet owners. Like many other diets common in raw feeding, it uses an acronym that describes the way the raw meal is formulated. But which diet is the most optimal for your dog? In this video, I'll be going over barf. This is number 2 of a 3-part series explaining 3 popular formulas, so make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you'll see when we upload the final video. So what does barf mean? Barf stands for biologically appropriate raw food. It's similar to PMR, or prey model raw, in the sense that it includes raw meaty bone, muscle meats, and offal, or organ, but the ratios are a little different than PMR as it includes vegetables, fruit, and fish. It may also include nuts, seeds, shellfish, and dairy, but I'll be going over those in my next video. This diet operates on the philosophy that dogs are omnivores and benefit from fruits and plant matter, as wolves have been observed eating this in the wild. The rough guidelines for this diet consist of 70% muscle meat, 10% raw meaty bone, 7% vegetables, 5% liver, 5% other secreting organ, and 3% fruit, with additions of oily fish throughout the week. The goal with these ratios is to mimic small whole prey animals as best as possible, while including some fresh whole foods to fill nutritional gaps. It's important to remember that these are just guidelines, and one dog may need more or less bone or organ than another. I would also like to mention that everything I go over in this video is for an adult dog. Puppies have different requirements as they don't have the ability to regulate nutrients. Just like PMR, whole prey can also be provided and is encouraged. What is whole prey? Whole prey is a whole animal completely intact, fur and feathers included. Animals that are often fed as whole prey are chicken, rabbit, duck, and quail. Whole prey should never be fed live and should always be frozen first, especially when feeding wild prey, which should be frozen for at least a month. So what are the benefits of feeding vegetables, fruits, and fish? Vegetables provide a variety of nutrients like fiber, which firms the stool and helps maintain a healthy colon. Additionally, the fermentation of fiber during digestion synthesizes vitamin K, which is an important factor in bone health and wound healing. Some of the best veggies to feed are dark leafy greens like spinach, kale, microgreens, collards, and dandelion greens. Since dogs lack the jaw structure to grind plant matter properly, veggies are best fed steamed, boiled, fermented, or pureed. Fruits are rich in antioxidants and are a source of glucose, which is used for energy. Berries like blueberries, blackberries, cranberries, and strawberries are the most optimal to feed as they are chock full of vitamins and nutrients like B vitamins and folic acid. Oily fish are high in omega-3s, which improves skin and coat health, and EPA and DHA, which regulates cellular inflammation and maintains nerve cell structure and function. Many fatty fish, such as mackerel and salmon, provide high amounts of vitamin D, in addition to EPA and DHA. Some other beneficial oily fish are herring, smelt, anchovies, and sardines. If you're feeding canned fish, make sure they're only canned in water. So what goes into making a barf meal? If I were making a full day's worth of food for my 25-pound corgi, this is what it would look like. Matsu needs about 1 ounce of raw meaty bone, 0.5 ounces of liver, 0.5 ounces of kidney, and 5 to 7 ounces of muscle meat. Today, I have beefsteak, pork loin, lean turkey, and chicken hearts and gizzards. I then add some berries, spinach, and I often puree my veggie medley, but for the aesthetic purposes of this video, I'm placing them in raw, and then some anchovies. The meat, bone, and organ equal around 9 ounces total, which is calculated by his weight, age, and activity level. I don't count in the additions into that weight either. All items you see in this bowl were either bought from my local farmer or Asian market. Other places to source meats and seafood are butcher shops, grocery stores, and online retailers that tend to sell more unique proteins and cuts, which I will link in the description below. Now that I've gone over PMR and barf, what should you choose? Unfortunately, these two varieties tend to create a divide between the raw feeding community. Ultimately, you should feed what makes the most sense to you after doing extensive research. Personally, I try to go a step further than barf, which will be my third and final video of this series, which you'll see here on the screen when it's released. And if you haven't seen our video on PMR, be sure to check that out too.